Ladies and gentlemen, Lucy's longtime friend, Carol Burnett.
During the past hour or so, we've seen a parade of women who had, as Noel Coward so beautifully put it, a talent to amuse. One face, one name, one lady stands out from the crowd. Her name, Lucille Ball. I had the honor of working with Lucy lots of times, and it was always a learning experience as well as a huge pleasure. First time we met was back in New York. I was working in a show called Once Upon a Mattress, and she came the second night right after we'd opened, and then, of course, she already was the queen of television. I thought I was going to die because I remember singing the one song that when I came out, and I could just see that red hair. Just sitting right there, the lights were shining on her, she was laughing, she was a sensational audience. I don't really remember the performance that well, except I was as nervous as I am right now. And she came backstage and to the dressing room. I didn't know how to act. I mean, do I kiss her ring or what do I, you know? Do I tell her that she's been my idol ever since radio days? Do I tell her I remembered radio? I needn't have worried because Lucy had that wonderful quality of putting people at ease in any circumstance, and she just sat down and we talked as if we'd been friends for 100 years. She was complimentary, she was helpful, encouraging, and later on I found out from many young actors and actresses that she was always that way, very nurturing to new talent. I wish I could offer some great new insight into her special talent, some revelation that would explain her unprecedented success and her longevity, but I can't, because all I know is that she was the best at what she did, and we are all so fortunate to have a record of that gift to warm us and delight us for generations to come. And even better than that, we have Lucy herself from a rare personal appearance at a seminar given by the Museum of Television and Radio, telling some of the stories behind her most memorable moments and her philosophy of comedy.
First, you have to believe it, no matter how unbelievable it is. And I had great writers, really. Now, you don't always have the greatest writers, but you still have to do it. But you have to believe, no matter how absurd, how unbelievable the situation is, as long as you've accepted the job and you're going to stick with it, believe. Believe.
Fine, you're doing splendidly.
I think there's great audience identification with Lucy. There always has been. Even with a slight change of format two or three times, there's always been audience identification. We have done domestic situation comedy with married people. That's with Bill and Vivian and Desi and myself. And then the next change, which was without the husbands, was certainly audience identification for millions of women who would try to go through life without a man. Of course, not as bungling as I, in some cases, but still identification.
We can't stash away 5 dozen eggs.
Well, we can give it a try. Here, open them up.
What are you going to do?
Well, I'm going to put some in my blouse.
Still feel those eggs. And the grapes are like stepping on eyeballs. A bat of eyeballs. Go ahead.
All those stunts seem to be planned out and everything else, but in the William Holden episode, when your nose catches fire. Was that planned or not?
No, it wasn't. No. Good question.
How do you do?
You have to excuse my appearance. I just washed my hair and I can't do a thing with it.
I had a great makeup man. And we talked about this thing that I had to be able to, it had to be very pliable, this thing that I had to put on quickly, and then I had to stretch it. By the time I got on the show in the hot lights, this got softer. And as I turned around and made the last thing on it, I pulled it too far. Now, when he lit my cigarette and the nose goes up, I remember thinking, you think I was surprised? Bill Holden almost fainted. Nobody ever enjoyed their work more than we did, not just me. Vivian and I had an absolute ball. We loved everybody. Well, so did everybody on the show. And it showed, I think.